this video, I'm going to set up Exclaimer Cloud signatures for Office 365. I've got two choices. I could set up the whole service, or I could just try the design interface. We'll come back to setting up the full service later. Okay, so I clicked Try the Designer. I can now click New Signature. I could either click Create Blank Signature and start from scratch, or I could click Skip and go straight into the example templates. I could have put in my logo and it would have filled in all this stuff with my logo and my details for me. But I'd rather just pick one of the example designs and go from there. So let's do this one. Okay, well that's not my logo. Let's delete that. I'll just go and let's drag in a logo. As you can see, the Exclaimer Cloud Designer is just drag and drop. Choose the logo I want to upload. Okay. Good. I also had to put a banner in here. So I'm just going to drag it into position, do the same thing again. I can drag and drop any elements I want. I could have done that with fields, with table layouts, whatever. But this is good. I need to add a little bit of padding just above that banner. All right. Excellent. Okay. So let's click Save, and I'll give this signature a name so it can save it under something. Cool. It's my first test signature. Let's click OK, and then close. So you'll notice if I click and I try and apply this signature to anyone, it says it's not available in preview mode. We need to configure the full service. So I click Configure Now, click Next, and now I'm setting this up really as a global administrator in Office 365. So first thing I need is the Office 365 domain name. I know mine off the top of my head, but as a rule of thumb, it's the domain name that ends in .onmicrosoft.com from the Office 365 dashboard. Let's click Next. And then if I click on My Account to enable it, great, it's giving us the read user profile and read directory data permissions so that I can pull across the contact details Exclaimer uses. Great, it's filled all that in. Click Next. Now here, it's going to create the connectors and the certificate that Exclaimer Cloud needs to interact with Office 365. So again, I'm going to type the credentials for my global administrator account. We're not going to keep these. Technically, I could delete this account after I run this wizard. It wouldn't have any impact on Exclaimer. I'm going to choose the top option, send all messages to Exclaimer Cloud. I could have chosen the bottom one to have it only process people in a certain group. I'll click Next, and it's just going to run a short wizard to create the secure certificate we need and the connectors rule and other elements Exclaimer Cloud needs. It's going to remove any existing Exclaimer connectors if you had them. In most cases, it won't need to, but it's because you can rerun this wizard to create new connectors again. It's going to create a receive connector and a send connector because the email is passed to Exclaimer. We put a signature on, and it's passed back. So it needs two connectors for those two passes between our Azure service and Office 365. A rule to decide which emails will actually be processed by those connectors. And then we add the Exclaimer Cloud IP addresses to your IP allow list. Because they're Azure IPs, we just want to make sure that your infrastructure never mistakes them for spam. Then I can click Next. And it's just going to synchronize the rest of the data from your Office 365 directory. Cool. So now I can click Next again, and the setup is actually finished. In here, I can click Applies To, and now I get this view, where I can assign signatures to groups, to users, even use an advanced query to narrow it down. I'm just gonna assign it to myself to start. I'll click OK, and then OK again. And then one last thing to do, I just wanna enable this, so that when I'm ready, it goes live. Perfect. Now, when I send an email, that's the signature that appears automatically. Thanks for watching.